The responsibility for protecting the public's health starts with the dishwasher. Your customers expect to enjoy safe food and beverages, and that begins with practicing good sanitation techniques. This is an instructional video to help you easily understand how to use and operate a single-tank, low-energy dishwasher. It will cover the following key steps: filling and operating, sanitizer concentration check, washing procedures, draining and cleaning, personal safety. To ensure the public's health, it's important to follow correct procedures and use the correct product and safety apparel. The dishwasher is designed for easy filling and operating. Filling. To fill the single tank dishwasher, first check to see if the drain in the lower pan is closed with the drain ball. Then make sure the power switch is on. You can now press and hold the fill button. As the machine fills, you will see the lower pan fill with water. When the water is about 2 inches from the bottom of the lower pan, release the fill button. Now, take a moment to observe the temperature of the wash tank to be sure that it is in the proper operating range. For best results, the temperature of the water should be a minimum temperature of 60 Celsius or 140 Fahrenheit. Chemical supply check. Always be sure to check your supply of detergent, rinse additive, and sanitizer before proceeding. If the product is low, replace it. Be sure to match the color-coded line tags with a newly added product. Detergent is red, rinse additive blue, and sanitizer is yellow. Then prime the chemical pump. With a dishwasher filled with hot water and the temperatures at the right level, the machine is ready for use. Sanitizer concentration check. Not only must the dishwasher clean wares, but sanitizing them is also the law. Your single tank dishwasher must rinse and sanitize wares at 60 degrees Celsius minimum. The sanitizer must be dispensed at 100 parts per million concentration minimum. To ensure sanitizer level meets the minimum standards, use the chlorine test paper to measure the level at the beginning of each shift before washing any wares. First, immerse the test strip into the sump pump water. Next, remove the strip and hold it up against the 100 ppm icon on the package to ensure that the color is the same or darker. This assures you have the right level of sanitizer in the water. Record the level tested in the daily sanitizer check log. If there is a problem, tell your manager, who will then contact Alpine for assistance. Operation: plates. Now that the dishwasher is filled with hot water, the temperature is right, and sanitizer concentration level is correct, you are ready to wash your wares. As the dirty dishes are returned to the dishwashing area, it is important to sort the dishes by size. Place a plate of each size on the sorting table and sort the dishes accordingly. Larger plates should be placed at the back of the rack and smaller plates at the front. Be careful not to overstack or crowd the dish racks. The dishes must be pre-rinsed with a pre-rinse spray unit before they are sent through the machine. The more thoroughly you pre-rinse the dishes, the better your results will be. Once you slide the rack into the machine and close the door, the machine will start. When the cycle is complete and the cycle light is off, open the door and remove the rack. Remember, clean dishes help assure happy customers. Be sure to properly wash your hands before handling the clean dishware. Operation: glasses. Place glasses and cups into their proper racks. Next, slide the rack of glasses into the machine and close the door. When the cycle is complete and the cycle light is off, open the door and remove the rack. Once the glasses are out of the machine, slightly jiggling the racks will help speed the drying process. Operation: flatware. Stainless steel flatware must be pre-soaked using a pre-soaked detergent and water in a tub. The flatware should soak for a minimum of 15 minutes prior to washing. Check with Alpine for proper product usage. Once the flatware has been pre-soaked, place the pieces of flatware in baskets, handles down, and in a random order to avoid nesting of the flatware, which can prevent proper cleaning. Nesting of flatware will lead to insufficient sanitation. Pre-rinse the flatware thoroughly and then slide the rack into the dishwasher. Upon exiting the dishwasher, pull out the rack and vigorously shake the basket and let stand till dry. Once the flatware has sufficiently dried, empty the basket onto a clean washcloth. Then, sort the flatware into their appropriate bins, being very careful to only handle the base of the utensil. By carefully following this process, the flatware is never touched by your hands, remains sanitized, and is ready for use. Draining and cleaning. The machine should be drained and cleaned after every meal period. First, turn off the power, open the inspection door, and remove the drain ball assembly and sump screen. Use the pre-rinse spray to clean the sump screen, and then place it back into the machine. You must also remove and clean the scrap accumulator tray. Use the pre-rinse spray to clean the tray, and then return it after cleaning. Next, inspect the lower and upper wash arms for debris. If the arms are clogged, remove them from the machine. You can remove them by pulling and twisting the pull pins for each arm. And then unscrew the end plugs. Use a toothpick to clean the jet nozzle heads, and use a wire brush to clean inside the spray arm. Finally, use pre-rinse spray to clean these parts. Once the arms have been cleaned, screw the end plugs back into the end of each arm. Prior to replacing the parts inside of the dishwasher, be sure to use the pre-rinse spray to clean out any debris. Place the wash arms back into the machine. Be sure to lock the pull pins back into position. Following the final cleaning of the day, it is best to allow the machine and its parts to air dry. Remember, your job is very important. By following these simple washing procedures and cleaning instructions, you will consistently produce sparkling clean, sanitized dishes. And that will reflect well on you.